Nick, you can forget that first round win. These coaches have to tell their kids it's one and done in this second round game between the Providence Friars and the Kentucky Wildcats.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Wildcats looking at a very capable opponent tonight, Dick. What are their keys to victory, do you think?
If I'm on a bench, Brad, my keys would be simple. Number one, pound the ball down low for some easy baskets. It'll be a bonus if you can get their big man in foul trouble. Second, it's imperative that you win the battle of the boards. Thirdly, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Well, that's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got him in a face-up position in the post.
Defender right up on the ball. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
For the bucket. They still don't score. The small forward takes the pass. He shoots from left of the circle, way off target. Now trying to feed the low block. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Gets it to go. Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up. He goes for three. Off the rim and no good. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. There's the pick. Number 23, pump fakes. Jumps in. Number three, makes the finger roll. Thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. High post flasher is open. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. They go into the low block. The power forward with the ball. Here's a double team and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
They work the perimeter. Down inside. There's a double team waiting there. The Friars have a mismatch in the post.
Can we get him the ball though?
Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Too much. That's a foul. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion. What passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Takes the pass in the paint for two. Doesn't go. To feed the low block. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Up and away, slam jam back. What muscle he's got, baby.
Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, he took a chance, and he lost, baby.
confronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect. So they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Foul charge. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Fake.
There's the trap.
Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. Way off target. Looking for a good shot. Now they work it around the perimeter. Shoots from outside. Off the rim and no good.
The crowd will be on cloud nine if they can put some points up on the board.
Fakes the shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dickey still applying great pressure on the dribbler. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Can't get the shot to go. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. He's got a nice shot fake. There they come with a double team to stop it. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
Nice high post screen. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
They can't stop this guy, Dick.
Want to give him a try, Brian?
If only my knees weren't aching.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. The shooting guard gets the pass. In and out. Working it around the perimeter. Top of the blocks it. They work it around the perimeter. On the outside, looking for contact. Too much contact there, and knocked him off balance a little.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Another turnover.
And we're not talking about the turnovers either.
Takes the shot off the baseline, way off target. They work the perimeter from the top of the circle. That's good. Gave it up. Tries the turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Steal, go up the other way, get a layup.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching, he's sitting.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Kentucky are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Stolen away. Here they come on the break. He's got the man on the high post if he can get it there. From the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. He buries the shot. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
In the paint. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He unloads a three. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Got a nice screen. Number 23 gets the ball. Goes up for two. And he missed. Number four takes the feed. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose. For the bucket, perfectly executed.
Hey, he should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move.
Nice hops.
The ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
From three-point land. Oh, yes. At the end of the first half, the Wildcats lead by three. It's been a tight battle so far, Dick. Do you have a highlight of the half in your book?
No bigger shot in the first half for me than this three ball from downtown, baby. Teams build the confidence they need when the threes are falling.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Kentucky came up huge on the boards in the first half.
You're right, Brad. They were extremely productive on cleaning the glass. They were like the Windex man. They were cleaning the glass. If you control the glass, you win the ball game, baby.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Erin. Trying to draw some contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
Push that basketball.
Looking for a good shot. The small forward handles the pass for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Picks off the lazy pass for two. Perfectly executed. And they get the turnover. They move it up in a hurry.
Hey, check out the mascot, baby. Is he into this or what? Judging by his reaction, I think he wishes he was playing. Wow, do you think he liked that last dunk?
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Not there. Trying to draw the foul.
Gotta make that, baby. Have a wide open angle. Have a chance to lay it on the glass for easy dunks.
Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Dumps it in. Takes the pass in the paint. He shoots from the top of the circle. Great shot. Number three is feeling great right now.
Well, he's had some success, and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now.
Looking for a good shot. He wants a three. Sinks it. On the inside. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing off is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first shot. Gets them both to fall. The Friars are down by four. Oh my, the screener is leveled by the defender on that pick.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
The fake. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover.
I tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Shoots it. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
On the outside, the shooting guard receives the ball from left of the circle. The Wildcats have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
They'll work it around the arc. Takes the and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
Dickey simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Gave it up in the paint. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a pull. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
The crowd really admires this young man.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it.
Tries for two. He pulls down the rebound. On the dribble, gives it up. He does the sweet fake shot. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The point guard receives the pass. Go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. The Wildcats have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
The power forward handles the feed. Goes up for two. When you're one of the top-ranked teams, you've got to bring your best every night. Teams are always looking to knock you off.
That's the price you pay for being at the top, Rod.
Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Takes the outside jumper, rims out.
That's basic.
Takes the pass in the paint for the bucket. The layup is good. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot. I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Number 13 with the foul. First personal foul.
Look at this, Mr. Nessler. He has a little something for the opposition. That, to me, is a no-no.
The Friars, they're out of rhythm, and they just look frustrated out there right now.
They've been shooting themselves in the foot. They better get their emotions in check. That's absolutely sensational, even a second time.
Gave it up in the paint.
Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
Takes it off him. Pump fakes. They're working around the perimeter. For the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He gets it to fall. He pump fakes. Goes up for two and off the mark. For two, and he scores despite the hack.
Let's take a look at that last basket. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere. He takes the shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good.
No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
There's the pick. There's the roll. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
And a momentary look from three-point land. They work the perimeter. Picks off the pass. It's a matter of clock management, isn't it?
Well, it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to be able to get to that winner's circle.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Number three to the charity stripe. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Hits his second.
I'm gonna TL, baby.
Yeah.
baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
He goes for the trifecta. Rims out. And the clock stopped with a foul. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Number 25 is going to the charity line. Pulls down the board.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
For the bucket. He puts it in with contact and all. Foul, and that stops the clock again. I think it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing, they're getting good shots and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
It's good. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
He attempts the three. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Both free throws go. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
He throws up the shot. He gets the shot to fall. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Nobody likes this point of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation so far.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble down the stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line and out of bonus situations.
He makes the second.
This is a key possession. They must score here, baby. It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
Looks at a three. Off the rim and no good. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Kentucky graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.